Like what you just heard? Well, tune in to Back from the Dead with Anna Snow on blazeradioonline.com. But don't just take my word for it. Here's what Bob Weir has to say. Or maybe you don't trust someone to talk about their own music. So here's an outside opinion on why you should listen to Back from the Dead.
A contemporary music critic has suggested that the four greatest musicians who ever lived in alphabetical order are Bach, Beethoven, the Grateful Dead, and Mozart.
Whoever you choose to believe, tune in Monday nights at 11 p.m. Peace and love, everyone.
Thanks in that bank.
Good Tuesday afternoon, and welcome into the Bill Austin Radio Studio to your favorite Traffic Jam crew. I'm Zach Bradshaw, alongside Kenji Ito and Mattie Freeze. Second to last episode of Traffic Jam, guys. I'm kind of sad.
I know. I'm actually really bummed. This has been so fun this semester.
This show has been like good.
Yeah, I kind of joined late, but you know, I've had a blast.
This show's been so fun.
Yeah, Kenji and I like joined like a month in to the semester, but
we're like, hey, what's going on?
Yeah,
and it just like worked out.
Exactly.
That's been so fun.
What a team.
I think we got a riot though, because our Blaze prom was on Thursday night. Last Thursday night, and we did not win.
It was last Tuesday.
Last Tuesday night. You're right.
Yeah.
Sorry,
that was last Tuesday. Because it was after our show.
It was after our show. You're right. Blaze prom, really fun. They had really good pizza. Everybody dressed up. It was really fun. Mm-hmm. Announced all the awards.
And where Zach won Freshman of the Year.
I did get Freshman of the Year.
Humble brag.
Did get Freshman of the Year. Humble brag. I was just like better than all of you guys, but
oh my gosh.
Nothing to brag about, right? I know that I'm smart.
But one thing that we did get gypped on is
we did not get Best Traffic Jam Cast.
Ugh.
Dang it.
So rude.
The only reason, okay, so there's like Traffic Jam Today's and there's the one on Wednesday, right? Mm-hmm. The only reason we didn't get it is because Gideon is like the Blaze director and he's on that show.
Yeah, it was totally, totally, like, favoritism.
It was
he
so
probably
rigged.
Gave himself that award.
It's so rigged. I was so mad about it.
No.
When they didn't say Tuesday Crew, I was like...
Single tear. No, Gideon would never rig it. He's too sweet, but...
He's too sweet, but still...
I'm sure they deserve it.
I don't think they... I've been on... Okay, I don't want to say anything. I've been on their crew, though, and they're just, like, they're not as good as us. Like, I'm not even going to lie. I'm not even going to lie. I'm sorry.
Oh my gosh.
I love them... I love them with all that I am, but...
Maybe they're not as off the rails as us. Maybe that's why they won, okay?
Yeah, possibly.
It's a Kalina's Blaze radio show.
Exactly.
Let's jump right into news, guys. We have a lot to get to today. Biggest news all over the internet, Elon Musk has officially purchased Twitter.
For $44 billion.
That is insane.
Yeah.
That's more money than I'll ever see in my life.
Yeah. But, you know, it's kind of crazy. This to think about. It's like, you know, I have $44 billion just laying around. You know, I'm just going to buy Twitter real quick.
That was funny. He was like, yeah, I set like $50 billion aside to like buy Twitter. I was like, what? Yeah. He's the richest man in the world, though.
Oh, exactly.
Is he?
He is officially, yeah.
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 That's so wild.
By, like, a long shot, too. Like, it's, like, not even close. Yeah. It's crazy.
That's
it's wild.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. The thing about him, though, that confuses me is, like, he wants to promote more freedom of speech.
Mm-hmm.
How do you do that?
Like, I mean, I think maybe altering, like, some of the, like, guidelines on Twitter. More content to be on there. Maybe. I don't know.
It feels like a pretty free like platform already, though.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
Which is weird. Other than Donald Trump being banned, but other than that.
Yeah, but maybe that did promote free speech.
Yeah, I don't know.
No, true. But also, like, yeah, no. There was a viral hashtag going around yesterday called #DeleteTwitter. And it was, like, basically if Twitter charges people to, like, use the service, people are going to, like, not use Twitter.
Is that something that's, like... in conversation, charging people to use Twitter?
Yeah, that's like in conversation right now. But
that's so weird.
How
is that promoting free speech then?
Exactly.
Like, wait, and that's like, what do you have to pay for every tweet you have to do? Or like, how would
like,
it work?
I think maybe a monthly.
Yeah. Oh. Just like be on it.
Then I'll never
use Twitter ever again. Yeah.
It's bizarre, right?
Yeah.
But like Musk came forward in an interview and said like, hey, we're not going to do that. But like, no, it's weird though. Because like, I don't know. Does Twitter Blue, which you already pay for?
Mm-hmm.
You have to pay for Twitter Blue.
I don't know what that is.
Really?
What are you talking about?
It's like some like subscription Twitter service, but it's like just like extra. It's basically Twitter, but like times two.
I see.
But like, yeah, it's weird though.
I feel like that's just like kind of a ripoff, honestly. Like Twitter and Twitter Blue.
You shouldn't have to pay for it. No.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But yeah, it was just weird though. The whole hashtag delete Twitter thing was like the most viral hashtag on Twitter's service. Mm-hmm. So kind of ironic, but
yeah.
Another news, the House GOP also said that Twitter should allow Trump to get back on. Literally, like, within, like, 20 minutes of this deal going through, the House GOP tweeted out there, like, hey, good time for you to, like, allow Donald Trump back on Twitter. And then people got mad.
Yeah.
I wasn't really on Twitter when he was on Twitter, so I kind of don't know about, like, his statements he made. But I probably bet it was, like, very political, as he is, and... I don't know.
Yeah, we'll see if they let him back.
After the Jan 6 riots, like...
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That was not good.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
But I think, like, Trump said, too, that he won't go back on Twitter regardless. Mm-hmm. So even if they do let him back on...
It'd be a symbolic thing.
Yeah. I guess he's, like, I don't know.
Yeah.
Hurt, petty by it, I don't know.
Who knows?
What would that mean, though, like, for Twitter? If you're Elon, because I don't know, this sounds crazy, but a lot of, like, California Democrats really like Elon, but they didn't like that he purchased Twitter. If he goes and, like, allows Trump back on to the service,
that'll just make him mad more. Like...
Yeah. Will they just, like, stop using Twitter, you think? Like...
No. I think Twitter is really popular among a lot of politicians. It gives them, like, an outlet to get their message out there in a way that's very, like, one, free.
Yeah, yeah.
But except, like, a lot of politicians have, like, a media people who they pay. But, platform. Like, the service themselves, itself is free. So I think it's a good way to get, like, information out. A lot of, like, news sites pull things off of Twitter a lot. So yeah. I don't see politicians pulling from Twitter. But I think they could be like, oh, we don't like Twitter.
Yeah. Plus it's another form of advertisement as well.
Yeah, exactly. Oh,
yeah. Yeah. I think Twitter too, like the reason a lot of people like it is because it's like more professional to like just send out like words. Okay, like on Instagram, you have to like post like a picture to get words in it, you know? Mm-hmm. But like on Twitter, you just like post like the actual words. But
yeah, it's more, like you can post a picture if you want. You don't have to put a picture. Like, you can put out what you want to put out.
It's like specific to words, I feel like.
Yeah.
Whereas Instagram is like pictures, TikTok, videos, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
And then Snapchat is a whole different story.
Snapchat's a whole different story, yeah.
Yeah. But I don't...
It's weird, though, because it kind of makes Twitter like a monopoly in the market. Which goes into like, okay, well, now that Tesla's becoming a more prominent car manufacturer, and then like SpaceX has like owned the space market for... is going to own the space market for a while. I mean, like, Elon's gonna be owning a lot of things. Like, what, do we?
I
like...
mean, he owns a lot of things, but I wouldn't call Twitter a monopoly in the market. You know, I mean, why did his name just leave my brain? Mark Zuckerberg owns Facebook and Instagram.
Yeah,
like if he owned Twitter too, that would be a monopoly.
You think so?
Yeah. But I wouldn't say like Twitter itself is a monopoly.
Yeah,
it's one platform.
That's true. Yeah,
and like. While I don't think people will like stop using Twitter unless it becomes like no longer free, people easily could like you could
totally.
Delete your Twitter account and just go
and totally be fine,
be on Facebook or good. Be on Instagram.
That's like, the good thing. Like it's a free market. Like you know, there's a lot of like competitors and stuff, so it makes it like good. Also, like 23% of Americans use Twitter, so it's like not as much as you. I mean, I would guess at least like 70%, but it's only 23% of Americans use Twitter, so
that's wild.
But yeah, no, so it's a big open market, so I don't know. Elon buying it out, I guess we'll see where it goes in the next few days and this Trump drama, just keeps going.
Other things happening this week is Lesbian Visibility Week, which celebrates lesbians and honors all queer women and non-binary homies, folk, if you will, within the LGBT plus community. Author J.K. Rowling decided to mark the occasion by, quote, saluting the resilience and courage of her inspirational friend, LGB Alliance co-founder, Allison Bailey. She said, this is the perfect example of how not to be an ally.
Yeah, we don't like JK Rowling.
Yeah. She said a lot of really controversial things about the trans community, about the LGBTQ plus community as a whole.
Yeah.
Her books might be good, but not her personality.
Yeah.
Or her political views.
Yeah. Linda Riley, who is the Lesbian Visibility Week founder, slammed JK Rowling as is when she said the perfect example of how not to be an ally.
Yeah.
Sorry, I had it written down twice.
No, you're good. That was my fault. I put it in the doc weird. No, I'm proud of Linda Riley. I'm thinking Lydia, our co-host here. No, Linda Riley, founder of Lesbian Visibility Week, had an interview, like, slammed J.K. Rowling.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, that's so needed because, like, when you have... I didn't even hear of Lesbian Visibility Week until today.
Oh, really?
I never heard about that. So, like, when you have one of these, like, grassroots movements that's, like, just getting started, when someone, like, a big author like J.K. Rowling goes out and, like, openly, like, degrades it, it's so big to have your founder just, like, push back. You know, it's, like, push back against the oppressors, essentially. So, I don't know.
Yeah, and I mean, some other LGBTQ news. Janelle Monáe came out as non-binary, which is awesome news in my book. They came out as pansexual in 2018, and she's announced that she'll be using she, her, and they, them pronouns. She said that she doesn't see herself as a woman solely. And I think it's very cool.
It's so cool.
Like, obsessed with them, so.
I love Janelle Monáe. They took more of, like, a religious approach. They said that, like, God is bigger than he or than she. And so, like, that's, like, Monáe's reasoning behind, like, she said, like, if I am God, I am everything. So, yeah. This is, like, so cool, though.
Yeah.
Generally, 'cause I don't think I can't recall anybody famous ever coming out as non-binary except for now, Janelle Monáe.
Yeah, I mean, there's definitely a few celebrities who have come out as non-binary. Demi Lovato is one.
Oh, yeah. I thought Demi Lovato was just transgender. Is that... Is she not, okay, no. Non-binary? Okay.
She's non-binary.
Got it.
Also uses she, her, they, them pronouns. They, them.
Yeah, yeah.
Demi Lovato is probably the one who made it most public, too.
Yeah.
Demi did.
That was... What, 2 years ago now?
It's like 2 years ago, yeah.
That's the most prominent, like, other person I can think of. So, like you said, like, we don't see this a lot, and I think this is, like, kind of a win for non-binary people to see, like, more representation.
To have the courage to go up and, like, to come out like this, it takes so much from people. Like, because, again, being non-binary, like, in the past just has not been ever, like, a thing. And, like, now it's just, like, it's like spaces are being able to, like, it's like, okay, like, you're okay to, like, come out, like, it's safe for you, like, you know, it's just like, it makes me so happy. I don't know, I guess I'm just, like, happy for people. There's a lot of work to go in terms of, like, acceptance of the LGBTQ community, but this is a big step, and I think, I don't know, we all respect the hell out of Janelle Monáe because they are in so much. Movies,
music,
albums, music, like, they do inspirational speeches. I mean, just, like, so much.
She's so incredible. And so I think, like, I myself use she, they pronouns. And so to see, like, such a prominent figure, and just somebody who I respect so much, come out in the same way, is so encouraging. And, I don't know. It's it's great news.
It just makes all the world a difference.
Yeah, absolutely.
No, it's just so inspiring. And especially during this time of, like, the Don't Say Gay Florida bill, like, it just all kind of ties in right now. I mean, we are, like, at the crux of, like, LGBTQ awareness right now. And, like, it is just, I don't know, being part of the community, too, it's just, it's fun to watch. Like, genuinely. I love to see the activism right now. Another news.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
I forgot this one was on the rundown.
This is a little strange here.
Oh,
so,
man.
Get
right into it, Zach.
Yeah.
Let's hear it.
Yeah.
So Megan Fox and MGK, the rapper, Machine Gun Kelly, had an interview with Glamour UK, and So basically in the interview, something kind of odd happened. They have a very odd ritual, and it's that, believe it or not, they drink each other's blood.
That's so weird.
Well, for, quote, ritual purposes.
Well, what kind of ritual? I don't...
Here's the thing, and I don't know if this sounds messed up or not, but am I that surprised? Is because...
Oh, I'm absolutely not surprised.
This makes no sense.
Look at MGK, and look You're at totally the right. type of guy he is.
But look at the type of woman that...
She is as well.
Megan Fox is. She's crazy. She's been crazy from day one.
Yeah.
And we knew. We've been new.
Yeah. After the Michael Bay days, like, she's turned into a crazy woman.
I mean, I think she was always kind of like this. She was marketed to us as this very Angelina Jolie,
exactly.
mysterious, yeah. insanely gorgeous, dark hair, light eyes woman who is like, she's insane. She's so, I mean, have you seen Jennifer's body? Like,
I know.
Like, it's so... not surprising at all. Yeah. It's just and then, weird. It's just weird. So weird.
Yeah. And then it's the... they also like publicly say it too. Mm-hmm. It's like
they don't care.
That's something you would like keep to your significant other, not like, oh, I'm on TV or wherever this was and I'm spreading the word out that I suck my girlfriend's blood or something. You know?
And then MGK like made that ring that like is stuck on Megan's finger, like the wedding ring.
Yeah.
It's like stuck on her finger and she takes it off, it'll like bleed or whatever. Like it'll like,
oh my God.
It's like stuck on essentially.
It's so weird. And I mean, their Instagram captions and like their comments to each other are so weird. Yeah. So, I mean, I agree, Kenji. I'm not at all surprised by this. Yeah. It's just weird.
We've never seen this.
So weird.
Exactly. I'm going to impersonate Megan Fox because her interview was so fun. I'm going to impersonate her really quick. She goes,
I'm ready.
It's just a few drops. Yes, we do consume each other's blood on occasion for ritual purposes only. Like, I swear.
Oh man.
Go back and watch it. It's so funny.
What is this? She's like, something about, like, Game of Thrones, drinking it from, like, goblets. So strange.
Yeah.
I can't.
I...
This is genuinely... And then they said the blood consumption is, quote, controlled.
Yeah.
Which I have no clue what that means.
I mean, I think it just means that they don't drink a lot of it.
Oh, because they're healthy.
Like, it's controlled amount. So it's not, like, considered cannibalism or something like that.
Well, I don't know if Machine Gun Kelly is healthy, because he's the definition of a twig.
He is very skinny.
So true.
But, I mean, so is she. I think...
They both are.
I think it's just another weird thing that they do.
I think it's because of all that blood loss.
No, this is bizarre. Another kind of national news. Kamala Harris, Vice President Kamala Harris, has tested positive for COVID-19. I don't know. Not big national news now because there's a lot of other stuff going on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Another news, kind of national. J.R. Smith, former guard for the Cavaliers. That's NBA. Got a very like strong celebration for getting a 4.0 GPA and actually won the North Carolina A&T State University Athlete of the Year, like Student Athlete of the Year. This feels so wrong to me because he's like 36 years old.
Mm-hmm.
He's retired. He went back to school to play golf.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, everybody's like, oh my gosh, you got a 4.0? When literally every day students do that like so much more often and they put... Mm. They put in so much more effort to their classes, I feel like.
Yeah. I think that why it's such a big deal is obviously because he's an NBA player.
That's the only reason.
And then the second thing is because he has done, like, questionable decisions and everything, you know. Like, I mean, like, he's done very stupid acts and, like...
Well, it's like, are we going to celebrate you for, like, doing some very mundane, like, kind of everything?
But
when, literally you're... Just because you're famous, like, you're getting all the clout for it, essentially.
But it's, like, kind of, like, at the same time that it's, like, wow, he actually can do something that is, like, high level and everything because of his past.
I wouldn't, like, I mean, I don't want to put down, like, getting a 4.0. Like, I wouldn't say that it's mundane. I think it's, like, hard to do. I don't have a 4.0.
Yeah.
But I have... friends who do, and they work their butts off for that grade,
and that's what it
but they're not getting national recognition for that. So,
or you know, or like student of the year,
so
it's like, why would he have to get that? I don't know.
Yeah,
exactly.
Just some quick updates on the Johnny Depp Amber Heard trial. I don't want to get too much into it. just because it's kind of a sticky situation.
So sad, too.
And it's just sad. But a couple quick updates. A psychologist who testified today in the trial said that Amber Heard has two personality disorders. Also today, Howard Stern called Johnny Depp a narcissist and implied that men cannot be abused. So those are your quick Johnny Depp updates.
Genuinely insane.
Yeah, I have lost a lot of respect for Howard Stern.
I'm not sure what's crazier, drinking blood or saying these comments.
Yeah. So that's it.
That was their type of like, oh, like men can be abused. Like, let's just like not listen to their voices. Like, no.
Yeah.
If anyone like comes forward with that, like, there should be like a fair and reasonable trial.
It's just, it's such a sad situation. There's so many things at play in it. And there's a lot of controversy. And the truth is we don't know exactly what happened at any point in this relationship.
Yeah.
But the trial that's happening now is not about the abuse. It's about the defamation. It's a defamation case about, did Amber Heard lie and did it hurt, Johnny Depp's, Johnny Depp financially and like
his movie opportunities,
yes.
And I think we're all kind of in agreement. Like it absolutely did. I mean, he lost the Pirates role, Pirates of the Caribbean. He lost the Fantastic Beasts role that like that just came out. So yeah, there's. Mm-hmm. It's so sad for Johnny though. I mean, I don't know. When we see him in movies, he's like such a good guy. Like
And he's such a talented actor as well.
He's very talented.
But
we'll see. We'll see how it goes on, and we'll see how it turns out. Some other news that really shocked me when I read it, it was so weird to me. Delta Airlines will now be paying flight attendants during boarding, which I did not know that they didn't already do.
Which is so bizarre.
After unions pushing, Delta to start paying, they have agreed starting June 2nd to pay flight attendants half of their hourly rates during boarding.
Not even their full hourly, like half their hourly
it's
rates.
It's so weird.
I thought they already got paid during boarding.
I did too, because
flight process.
It's part of the process. They're literally working. Like, it's not like they're.
And it's also such like it's like so time consuming and such an like this is a terrible word to use, but it's a nag and everything for these flight attendants.
Yeah,
no, totally.
You gotta get everyone like participating and get everyone on board. It's
in their seats. Like they clean up before flights and stuff too. Like and after, which is just so weird. But also. I also thought they were on salary. Like, I thought they were on, like, a yearly salary.
I guess not.
I don't know it was hourly.
Yeah. This story didn't get into that. It just talked about they'll be paid half of their hourly rates. Also, starting back in March, they received a 4% increase on their wages. So this is being added to that.
It's so bad that, like, they had to, like, the workers had to unionize just to like hold the company accountable to do this
to get paid for literally working. Yeah,
ridiculous.
So that's my weird news.
Yeah.
In international news, Russia has shut off gas supply to Poland and Bulgaria, which guys, I just went to Tucson this weekend. I spent I think like $90 on gas.
Oh my gosh, to go to Tucson?
I drive a small car.
Are you kidding?
A small like four-door sedan car. And it was like
$90 to go to Tucson?
Yeah, from here.
That's unbelievable.
No!
I did see a funny tweet about this though. People are calling it the car owner virus. Coronavirus, car owner virus.
Oh, I get it.
Get it?
Yeah.
Mattie is giving me the most smug look right now.
Oh my gosh. I'm driving to Texas next week.
You're driving to Texas?
Yes.
Oh my God.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man.
Brings up a point though. Gas is the highest it's ever been in Idaho. 4.44 a gallon, and nationally it's an average of 4.11 a gallon. But crude oil this week is down more than $20 a barrel, which is a decline of 20% from its peak in March. But gas prices are still very high, so in economic terms, you have to kind of like stave off like whatever. So like they're gonna keep gas prices high for a while to make up for whatever lost revenue they had during that time. But
yeah.
Oh my god, more of this.
It's just so crazy and it's so expensive.
Yeah, you got some sports for us, Kenji?
Yeah, let's first start off with some kind of sad news. ESPN analyst and play-by-play broadcaster Kirk Herbstreit announces that he has a blood clot. Unfortunately, he's such a likable guy, and just him to have that is very, very heartbreaking. And then let's go into actually some very, jumping to very serious sports news. Jerry West, famous Lakers legend and amazing GM, he demands retraction about his portrayal in HBO's Winning Time show, which is about the Lakers dynasty back in the 80s. And West also vows to take HBO to Supreme Court over Winning Time depiction. And this is why, is because Jerry West is portrayed as this alcoholic. He is a total, like, mean mugging guy and everything. And what he is in real life is, like, calm, super, like, super low-minded. And, like, he's the exact opposite of what the show is doing. And he just doesn't feel well about it and everything. And he's doing these things, and I think it's good for him.
Yeah, basically defamation is what he's going to take him on for.
Yeah, exactly. And then just two other sports things is actual sports things. Boston Celtics sweep the Brooklyn Nets, very surprisingly, which is the first sweep in the 2022 playoffs. And then WNBA, you know, we can all agree that they have very entertaining logos and mascots, and they start in 10 days with the Washington Mystics versus the Indiana Fever.
Yeah, it should be a really fun WNBA season. Mm-hmm. Cannot wait to that. I'll be going to the Mercury versus Aces game on opening night. So
as you should.
Should be fun. Yeah.
WNBA has the best, like, mascots.
Oh, yeah. So fun.
They're better than the NBA
mascots, we in all my agree. Opinion. The names of WNBA teams are, like, the coolest.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like the Washington Mystics? Are you kidding? Yeah. I love that.
That's so cool. Phoenix Mercury, like, LA Sparks. Absolutely. But sounds awesome.
The big question is, which jerseys are better? The WNBA or the NBA?
I feel like the Mercury ones are really good. Those orange and black are just so slick.
Yeah.
Silky smooth.
Yeah. Definitely like.
Yeah.
Well, guys, it's almost 6:27. I could not think of the time for some reason.
While you're directly looking at it.
Yeah.
My goodness.
Almost 6:27, meaning we got to leave the Bill Austin Radio studio. However, listeners, make sure to tune in next week because
it'll be our last one.
Last Traffic Jam episode. But we're going to have fun. We're going to play trivia games.
Oh, are we really?
We're
going
to play trivia games the whole time.
OMG, a party.
Unless there's, like, crazy news of, like, Elon Musk buying out, like, Instagram or something.
Could you imagine?
Trivia.
Then we'll be doing playing trivia the whole time. It'll be a lot of fun. Make sure to tune in 6 o'clock next Tuesday. Yeah. And it'll be the first Tuesday of May, so you're going by fast, so I don't know. Party in the Bill Austin Radio Studio, right?
Yeah, exactly.
For your favorite Traffic Jam Tuesday crew, I'm Zach Bradshaw.
I'm Maddie Freeze.
And I'm Kenji Ito.
We will see you next week.
Hey, this is Colin from Grayscale. You're listening to Blaze Radio.
I kept on.